This is the last word exclusive.
From the U.S. health insurance company Blue Cross Blue Shield Association, conducted an analysis and concluded that the health risks that millennials are exposed to are greater than any other generation. The conclusions were drawn from a study of 55 million U.S. residents with commercial insurance who turned 21 to 36 years old in the year 2017. As it is difficult to believe, but according to an unfavorable prediction, it's expected that the mortality rate of millennials could be 40% higher compared to Generation X at the same age. Three terrible threats loom over them, and the most significant one is depression. The millennial generation is very active. There's the morning jog, stress at work, and hard studying. And also, you can't forget about the family and meeting with friends. With a phone always in your hands, there are 100 chats, 300 messages a day, a flurry of information that the brain simply doesn't have time to process. Such stress takes its toll on mental health. Since 2013, among millennials, there's been an increase in the prevalence of deep depression by as much as 47%. But one in five of them doesn't seek help. A total of 2 million privately insured Americans that have been diagnosed with major depression don't go to the doctor. American journalist Malcolm Harris, author of the best-selling book Kids These Days, Human Capital and the Making of Millennials, believes that American millennials have a minimal level of trust and they even outdid the previous Generation X. According to some, this includes those born from 1965 to 1979. According to others, from 1961 to 1981. Only 1 in 10 millennials say that they can trust another person. Millennials have not been spared from burnout either. According to the American writer Anne Helen Peterson, from their very childhood, millennials were taught self-optimization of every aspect of life to survive. As a child, all activities were totally controlled by their parents, and this has given negative results. Millennials constantly feel empty and exhausted. Even simple tasks like laundry or grocery shopping are complex, since work sucks all the energy out of them and leaves no room for anything else. Michael P. Leiter, a professor of organizational psychology who studies burnout, has added to the image of millennial dependency on the internet that blurs the boundaries between work and play, preventing the body and mind from properly recovering. The second, no less serious threat to millennials is poverty. The richest generation is considered to be the baby boomers, those born before 1964. When they reached the average age of 35, they owned 21% of national wealth. Over the next 4 years, the millennial generation will begin turning 35, but they won't even be able to claim 1/5 of total wealth. According to MarketWatch, one of the largest American online financial portals, the economist Gray Kimbrough, using data from the Federal Reserve System, compiled a chart that illustrates a serious wealth shortage among millennials. Boomers currently boast more than half of national wealth, 57%, while Generation X owns only 16%, and millennials, 3%. Millennials need to triple their net worth in order to catch up with Generation X over the next 4 years. And to achieve the level of boomers, they need to increase their wealth by 7 times. And this is a pretty difficult task, says a MarketWatch expert. Most millennials are overwhelmed by student loan debt, which reached a record $1.6 trillion. The Federal Reserve estimates that more than a third of 45 million debtors are under 30 years old. This all shouldn't come as a surprise. The 2008 global financial crisis hit millennials hard. Slow wage growth, high living expenses, and a lack of pension savings mean that millennials will play catch-up until retirement. This all affects the welfare of millennials and weakens their health. At present, millennials are the largest participants in the labor market. In the USA, for example, they make up more than 35% of all workers. In the worst-case scenario of the oldest millennials, in 10 years, they expect to earn $4,500 less per year as compared with the amount that the youngest representatives of Generation X earn today. Jason Dorsey, an expert on generations, argues that people aged 30 to 40 years old and a little older will still be largely dependent on their parents. People over 30 will still live with the older generation, and even the parents of some people over the age of 40 will still pay their cell phone bills. This phenomenon will be a burden for the older generation. It will become a reality if there's no rapid growth in income. The rapid introduction of artificial intelligence also threatens to leave millennials out of work. Using the calculations of Carl Benedict Frey and Michael Osborne and the independent research of the American Institute of Public Opinion, they determined the risk for each generation of losing a job due to the development of artificial intelligence and found that millennials are the most vulnerable. Almost 4 out of 10 millennials, 37%, are seriously at risk of losing their jobs due to automation. According to analysts, positions occupied by professional millennials are easy to automate. It may be insulting, but artificial intelligence can easily handle the work that most of them do. Already, bots are successfully writing articles, protesting parking fines for parking, and diagnosing diseases. The optimistic news is that the introduction of artificial intelligence in work processes will be gradual enough to allow millennials to adapt and keep up with the times. Depression and poverty can be quite scary, but death from despair is even worse. And this is the third danger lurking for Generation Y. Over the past decade, there's been a notable upsurge among millennials of so-called deaths from despair, those associated with drugs, alcohol, or suicide. These numbers are even too scary to say out loud. In 2017, death from despair claimed the lives of 36,000 millennials. Mortality from drugs, alcohol, and suicide has increased in almost all age groups, but this growth was especially pronounced among younger Americans. According to the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, in the period from 2007 to 2017, annual drug-related mortality increased by 108% among adults aged 18 to 34 years. Mortality from alcohol increased by 69% and from suicide by 35%. Why are millennials so neglectful of their own lives? The reasons are pretty clear. Youth pushes us towards reckless actions, while at the same time, we feel pressures from our financial problems. Student loan debts, medical insurance, mortgages, and expenses related to raising children all make millennials go on a one-way trip called death from despair. The forecasts of the American Insurance Company paint a gloomy picture of the future for millennials. But is it possible to rewrite the script? I think it is. Now, millennials are considered the largest generation living on Earth. This means that almost every important decision in each of the spheres of a person's life that have to be made are being made by Generation Y. morning runs, toast with an avocado, and a selfie on Instagram. Of course, no one ignores these things, but it's important to maintain mental health as well, often arranging for digital detoxes, quality rest, and conversations with a therapist. By the way, let's count in the comments how many millennials have watched this video. Let us know if you are one.